time now for everybody's favorite guessing game, What's My Line? Brought to you by Remington Rand, makers of the world's number one electric shaver, the Remington. Now, let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
Thank you. And on my left, to my left, at my left, a charming fellow who has stopped just a moment on his tour, who has been traveling around the country. I understand that he goes to Hershey, Pennsylvania tomorrow, and that he has a bigger advance sale in South Pacific, Annie, Get Your Gun, Ben-Hur, South... What were the others, Victor?
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma, Victor Borga.
And at and on from my left, the internationally famous and most charming columnist, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
And on my left, our regular colleague in this spot, the benign publisher of the American College Dictionary, Mr. Bennett Sir.
On my left, a man who uses practically every word in that American College Dictionary every week on this program, our distinguished moderator, Mr. John Charles Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. And panel, I've got some grand news for you tonight.
Oh.
Yeah. Put on your blindfolds, please. Once again tonight, we're going to begin with a challenger who has some area of identification, which, if you were not blindfolded, would give you an advantage which we don't feel is quite fair. So if you put on your blindfolds, please, we'll be very pleased with you. And when it's all over, you'll be very pleased with us. It's a promise always that we'll be a little bit extraordinary when we do this sort of thing. We'll also have a famous guest challenger before our panel a little bit later in the show. So, panel, sharpen your wits. We'll meet our first challenger in just 30 seconds.
Remington,
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 Remington now guarantees.
Pay attention, Mac.
Cleaner shaves for 15 days.
All your money back.
Thank you, Brushface. That's right, friends. Remington now guarantees cleaner shaves. So pick up a Remington on the 15-day free home trial plan. You have nothing to lose but your whiskers.
And now we meet our first contestant. Will you come in and sign in, please? First of all, ascertain from our challengers that you're familiar with our scoring system, are you? Fine. If you are, we'll let the people at home and our friends here in the theater know exactly what your line is. So, just to remind you again, panel, you are blindfolded because there is possibly an area of costuming or something of that nature which would be too revealing to you. We will tell you that our guest is salaried. We'll begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
That's yes.
Do you appear before the public?
That's yes, too.
Oh. Do you do some type of performing?
That's yes, too.
Does what you do entertain or amuse?
That's yes, too.
Would it entertain men and women at the same time?
That's yes, too. Glad I'm here.
Is there more than one person?
Here?
Besides you, John.
Oh, you mean your question, is there more than one person here beside
present,
me?
Yes, that we're trying to guess.
That's yes, too.
Oh. Is there more than two? Are some of them ladies?
That's yes, too, Doris.
Are most of them ladies?
You mean a majority of them ladies?
Yes.
Well, I guess we'd have to be fair and give you a no on that. We finally got that one out of the way. The majority of them are not necessarily ladies. That's one down and nine to go.
You mean necessarily?
Is it my turn now?
It is now, yes.
Mm-hmm. Would this be some kind of a singing aggregation?
Bennett, there you go.
No.
They talk sometimes and tell stories, but we don't think of them as singing in our world. That's two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Are all of them performers? They sound like the poor little
tire.
Kittens.
What say, dear?
They sound like the poor little kittens that lost their mittens. They are all performers. They were eager about that. They perform as on television. Oh, they're glad. Do they perform regularly on television? Lucky. Do they perform on a special show that is their own? It's not theirs.
Cats.
You know, people do overeat at Easter, don't they?
What happened?
That was all supposed to mean yes.
Oh. They're crazy cats on a hot tin roof. They're on their own show, and it's quite a group of them. Did Dorothy find out how many there were?
More than two, that's all.
More than two? It sounds like more than 22. do they only talk?
You mean with reference?
I mean, they don't play an instrument or Dorothy said they didn't sing or Bennett said they didn't sing. Do they just talk when they perform?
Well, I think, actually, Arlene, to be fair, we would have to give you a no there, because sometimes...
They do
sometimes,
something other
as a matter
than
of
talk.
Fact, they do perform in the general areas of terpsichore and music, etc., and so forth. That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Borger.
Well, I'm completely lost. Am I facing you?
Well, not quite, Victor, but it's all right. I can hear everything you say.
Good. What do I say? They are performers.
That's right.
And they are not necessarily ladies.
No. The question was the majority. Were the majority of them ladies?
The majority of them are not ladies. Well, since we don't know how many there are, we wouldn't know what the majority is either.
That's right.
They perform. That's correct. Huh?
That's absolutely right.
Mm-hmm. I might as well jump because what can I do here, blindfolded? Do they other things than sing or gesticulate as they were. Whom am I looking at now? I don't know. Do they do other performances than singing or give out sounds?
Yes, actually, the question has been answered in part previously, Victor. They do perform in other areas than one has mentioned so far tonight.
I see. Well, since I did so well, I'm going to pass.
Mr. Borger passes, Miss Kilgallen.
You have said that this group is on television. Has the television program that they are on ever been on more than once a week? Has it been on what we call across the board?
No, really, I couldn't say that we've been on.
That's
4 down and 6 to go, Mr. Sir.
Arlene, kind of snort of recognition.
Yes,
didn't
you?
No, I did not. So I'm going to pass it right on to Arlene.
All right,
Miss
Arlene.
Well, the snort of recognition was because the lady that dared speak that I can understand now, if it's who I think it is, why they've been going, because all of us know all of them. Is that true?
Really?
Yes,
really.
God.
No, I really do think that it's true.
That voice belongs to a woman who belongs to a man who sat at my left a week ago and has before, and I think it's Jane Meadows. Is that right?
That's right.
And that must be the panel that she's with, as Faye and Bill.
Go on.
Bill Cullen and
Henry Morgan
and Gary Moore.
Right.
I've got a secret.
That's right.
Now, was that supposed to be Catherine Hepburn?
It was.
We thought it was great in the dressing room, didn't we?
You can come out now.
I thought it was the Brooklyn Dodgers.
What do they do besides talk? Which is the dancer?
Well, now, actually, Jane and Faye explained that they get up and do a dance or sing a song, depending on what the show requires.
We do when I've got a secret.
Sure.
Yeah, we have a very interesting show.
Well, I must say, it's good of you all to come and see us and panel, meet the panel, will you? And will the panel please say hello to the panel? It's good to have had you all with us.
Hello, buddy. Hello, Denzel.
All righty. We got things back in order again, and panel, that was a little bit, I think, hard work for you, but you did it, Mr. Borger. Congratulations. You thought it was very easy. Fine. Well, let's see what you can do with another challenger. Will you come in and sign in, please, sir?
I'm ready.
Oh. No, Vic, you don't have to this trip. Ben Frick, is that right, sir?
That's right.
How are you? You any relation to Ford Frick, who runs the baseball world, the commissioner?
No, just a namesake.
Well, he was with us last week.
That's I see it.
Nice to have so many of you with us. Will you take a look at the panel?
I surely will.
Oh, you stay with me. Where do you come from, sir?
I come from Dungeness Base, Scrim, Washington.
Scrim, Washington.
That's
fine.
Right.
Well, let's fool him. You come on over and sit down next to me right away, quick, will you? And I'll ask you if you're familiar with our scoring system, are you?
I sure am.
All righty, then let's let the people at home and our friends here in the theater know exactly what your line is. Okay? All right. Panel, Mr. Frick is self-employed. With that, let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Frick, is there any product connected with what you do?
Yes.
Is it useful?
Mr. Frick, would you come in closer, please? Thank you very much. All right, sorry.
Is it a useful product?
Yes.
Is it found in the home?
Yes.
Is it also found outside the home?
Yes.
Is it alive?
It is, sometimes.
Sometimes it's alive and sometimes it isn't. That's tough.
This is when you find it.
Oh.
Depending on who you are, you know.
Is it an animal?
Yes.
A four-footed animal?
No.
Four-footed? No, I don't...
Are you thinking of two hands and two feet? That's not fair, you know. We've had that problem
with
monkeys.
You mean, you think that if we have two hands and two feet, we ought to consider that four-footed?
All right, so it's an eight-footed animal.
There you go. One down and nine to go, Mr. Borger.
It is a product, and it can be found in a home... And it has no... I'm just going over the whole thing
yes,
now.
Yes, you're right.
Because I'm...
very helpful.
Go over the feet. What did we establish?
Yes, that's
that?
What. That's why I wanted to... No feet.
The question was, is it a four-footed animal? And the response was in the negative.
And it can be found in the home and not outside.
Yes, that's
outside.
Be
outside
the home outside, too. Well, that makes it easy.
You know now.
It can be almost anything. With 4 feet, that can be found in a home and outside
the
home.
The question was, is it a four-footed animal? And the
how many
answer
legs?
To that is no.
The answer is no. I haven't asked it yet. I'm sorry.
No to Arlene.
Oh, it was no to Arlene.
I always get no answers. There's nothing else.
It has four
No, it doesn't. This is what it doesn't have.
It doesn't have four.
The question was, is it a four-footed animal? The answer was no. That's the no answer that we have up here already.
Okay.
You want to go over it again, Victor?
Could we have a short conference?
Yes, you can have 15, 20
Victor,
seconds for a conference.
The one thing it hasn't got is 4 feet. It might have two, it might have eight, it
or
might
none.
Have 100.
Or none.
Or none.
Oh.
But it's an animal.
Well, it could be a
snake. All right, but it hasn't got 4 feet. Divorce your mind of 4 feet.
I see. That makes it very tough. Now, is it something that you produce, you raise?
No.
Nothing you raise.
But it is an animal.
Yes, but
it is an animal.
Yeah. But
wait just a moment, please. Oh. I want to get this straight. You said it was, I wrote it down here, it was a product involved, right?
That's
now,
right.
If you don't raise it, what do you do with an animal with how many feet?
Right. This will all come out later, Victor. But Mr.
Trick,
I'm sure you will agree, does not raise these.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I think it'd be a little too difficult.
I don't know if I should be sorry, but I am sorry.
Two down a date to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Now, this creature, has it more than 2 feet?
Yes.
More than three?
Yes.
More than four?
Yes.
Is it in the insect family?
Ah, there we go.
No.
No.
That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
More than four feet
and is not in the insect family.
And we are using very general terminology here. I want to put you on notice on that.
Yes.
Because I think it would be too rough on you if I were to get very exact in terminology here.
You are not at all exact, John. In fact, I don't know what you're talking about. Does this creature slither on the ground? Does it ever
slither.
Sort of slide along the ground on its stomach as well as using its feet?
Let me have a small conference.
You're making it sound so unattractive.
Well, more than I think.
Yeah. Interesting. Too. Yeah. Actually, I tell you what, let's leave here and go talk about this. No, let's stay around. Actually, Bennett, I would say this. Mr. Frick tends to agree with you that you could describe in general terms that this is an animal that creeps and crawls when it locomotes.
Oh.
Mr. Frick, is it any member at all of the snake family?
No.
Four down and six.
Yes.
To go.
Excuse me.
Oh.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Is it any member of the tarantula or caterpillar family?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Borger.
What do you do with it?
What do you do with it? Well,
what do you do with an animal that isn't anything? It can't do anything.
Is it?
It is an insect.
No, it's not an insect.
It's been determined that it's not an insect.
From the beginning again, maybe we can get get back some of the loot. It is not an insect. We've got over that.
We got over that.
Can I wait till next week? I'll pass. I have no...
All right, I'm going to give you one more minute on this panel, Miss Kilgallen.
Is it found on ground rather than in the water?
Is it found on ground rather than in the water? Mr. Frick?
Well,
a crab could be on the ground.
No, I think.
I say no.
That's right. That's six down and four to go, Mr. Sir.
I presume it's edible. Is that correct?
That's right.
If it were eaten, what might it come under the designation of seafood?
Yes.
It would. Might it be either in the lobster or crab category?
No.
No, that lets the minute go by. Mr. Borger, what is it?
It lives in the house. Is it a snail?
A snail? No.
Snail?
It is not a snail. Mr. Frick is an octopus fisherman.
Oh, octopus.
Oh. Oh, up Objection. Objection.
What is the objection?
Go ahead.
File the objection.
Octopus hasn't got legs.
Arms.
No legs for an octopus. Eight is to have arms.
You will remember when you raised the question of legs, I took great care to say we are speaking in very general terms because
well,
if we do not, it will confuse
leg,
you.
That's extremely general.
Well, that's how general we were getting.
Going too far. Going too far.
But, Mr. Frick, thank you for sticking the panel. They had a lot of fun being stuck, I think.
Well,
and thanks very
thanks
much for being our guest. Nice to have you with us in What's My Life. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here's a word from Dick Stark.
Friends, earlier the Shavians and I told you about...
Oh, let me, Dick! Oh. I can do it! See? Just like you. Friends, earlier the Shavians and I told you about Remington's... that Remington guarantees cleaner shaves for 15 days. Why this guarantee? Because we know that unless you actually try the new Remington, you'll never believe it can give you such a clean shave. That's why we urge you to try it. Try it.
Wait
just
a minute.
Try
Whoa
it.
There, little shaver. Now, just look. You mustn't oversell, you know?
You can't oversell a Remington.
Well...
It's such a great shaver.
Of course, friends, the Shavians are right, and that's why Remington urges you to make the 15-day free test and prove it for yourself.
You have nothing to lose but your whiskers.
Well, Shaver, you are right again. Now, friends, you get your money back if you're not convinced, but we know you will be. You remember this demonstration where a Remington shaves off a 2 weeks' growth of beard in a matter of moments? Now, this test itself proves to you how great the Remington really is.
But the best test is the one you make for yourself.
How about that? Isn't that really great? Friends, use the Remington for 15 days and then just try going back to your old method of shaving. We double dare you. You'll be spoiled for anything else. So, men, give it a good try. Will you do that? And look, if you have an old standard make electric shaver around the house, bring it in because it's worth a giant $8.50 trade-in. Not $7.50, mind you, but $8.50 more than anyone else offers. So tomorrow, choose your own Remington electric shaver. Either the man-size Remington 60 Deluxe or the brand-new Remington Foursome, and then take advantage of Remington's 15-day free trial plan. Remember this, Remington guarantees...
Just a moment. Allow us, Mr. Stark. Come, gentlemen.
Remington guarantees...
Cleaner shaves for 15 days or your money back.
Now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which my friends on the panel are once again blindfolded. Blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes, still there. Yes.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? All right. Panel, as you know... In the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different pattern of questioning. You ask one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise. We'll begin it all with Bennett, sir.
Well, before I start guessing, I must tell you that it just turned out that Dorothy Kilgallen thinks an alligator has six legs. You better see one later, alligator. Can I presume that we are back in the category of show business? Are you well known in show business?
That's, yes,
same
Bennett.
Oh,
that's the mouse that goes with the cats we had in the first round.
Miss Francis.
Have you appeared in pictures?
What's more
that?
Conference.
The seal.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Borger.
Have you appeared on television?
Miss Kilgallen?
Was that a yes?
That was a yes.
Are you, and it was a no to pictures.
That's right.
Are you or have you ever been in the theater?
Uh-huh.
Mr. Sir?
I think I recognize the voice. Have you ever appeared in previous years, were you part of a very famous team that broke up?
Mm-hmm.
Miss Francis?
Are you on television now? Are you appearing now on television? I don't mean this minute, but are you in a regular show of your own?
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Bulger.
Are you here, Victor?
I can't see. Oh, yes. Have you recently done... I think I know, but I'm not going to take a chance on it. Have you recently done a very successful nightclub act or supper club act?
Mm-hmm.
Miss Kilgallen?
Have you ever appeared at the Copacabana?
Mm.
That's three down and seven to go,
What's
Mr.
That?
Sir.
No?
That was a no, was it not?
I've got to take a guess because I think I know. I think it's Imogene Coco.
You're right. Oh, I was afraid of that, Miss Imogene. One word you said, I could just see Bennett's ears perk up, and I afraid that was going to do it. Actually, young lady who has cut a very wide path in this medium we all serve, and with very great distinction, you're going to try something new now. You're going to do a dramatic part, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
I think I read the papers correctly on CBS?
That's right.
Good. I'm not allowed to mention any other network, you know. I'm glad. When is it going to be?
April 11th.
April 11th. Well, wonderful. It's something we can all look forward to. Sorry we didn't give him a rougher time, but I'm afraid that wonderfully distinctive voice of yours is very hard to disguise. Very hard. Thanks for being our guest. Will you say hello to the panel? Now, before our panel says goodnight, may I remind you to tune in again next Sunday at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, when once again we invite you to play What's My Line. For other localities, check your local listings for the date and time of our weekly series. And starting next week, by the way, What's My Line will have a new sponsor, Helene Curtis. And now a word about one of their products.
Remington,
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 Remington now guarantees.
Pay attention, Mac.
Cleaner shaves for 15 days.
Or your money back.
Thank you, Brushface. That's right, friends. Remington now guarantees cleaner shaves. So pick up a Remington on the 15-day free home trial plan. You have nothing to lose but your whiskers.
And Miss Imogene Coker just sent word that any money she'd won should go to the Red Cross, so that's easy. We just flip all the rest of the cards, and that's a hint for what the rest of you might be willing to do tomorrow morning. And now, until next week, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Arlene Friend.
Ah, good night, John, and happy time in Florida, Victor. Good night. It was lovely
Thank
to
you.
Have you with us.
Thank you. Good night, Dorothy.
Good night, Victor. Nice to see you again, and have a marvelous time in Texas, Bennett. Good night.
Yes, we are traveling around, aren't we? Good night, John.
You going to Texas?
Going to Texas, too.
Victor's going to Florida?
Yes, sir.
No, I'm going to Hershey tomorrow for a week.
then I'm
going to Miami.
Oh, then you're going to Miami. Well, Victor, yeah. It was wonderful having
I
you
with
us. I
got calluses on my eyelids here from this thing here.
Oh, we're going to get you a new blindfold for the next trip. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us on What's My Line?
Travel arrangements on What's My Line are made through American Airlines. American Airlines flies our contestants in luxurious comfort aboard DC-7 flagship. This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network. Be sure to watch Remington Rand's other television program, Caesar's Hour, on another network. Check your newspaper listings for time and station.